Now let's move on and talk about unemployment and full employment and see the relationship between these two different concepts. There are a couple different types of unemployment, and the first one that I want to mention is called frictional unemployment. Now, frictional unemployment is just the unemployment that arises from regular labor turnover, from people entering and leaving the labor force, and from ongoing creation and destruction of jobs, or people who are just in between jobs. It is a permanent and healthy phenomenon in a growing economy. Let's put it this way, illustrate it visually. So we have three types of groups of people here. We have those who are employed, those who are not in the labor force, and we have a pool of people that are unemployed, and this we're going to say specifically people that are frictionally unemployed. So when we get people not in the labor force entering the labor force, generally we can say that they're unemployed. They're still looking for jobs. They haven't found one yet. And so the unemployment rate goes up when people enter the labor force. But then when you have unemployed people leaving the labor force, not working, of course, then you have a decrease in frictional unemployment. But at the same time, if you have people who are employed who lose their jobs, then they enter this pool of frictional unemployment. And people who are unemployed who find jobs, then you have people who are no longer unemployed, frictionally unemployed, and they are rather employed. So an example for this employed and unemployed, frictionally unemployed, would be someone who doesn't like their job, maybe, who leaves their job, looks for a new one, and finds another one. So they are employed, they leave their job, they are unemployed, then they find a job, and they're employed. So the frictional unemployment rate changes in this way. We also have structural unemployment, and there are three different things that can cause this. So first thing is changes in technology. They change the skills needed to actually perform jobs. For example, a secretary back in the day might have had to have really, really good bookkeeping skills, but a secretary nowadays would need to have extremely good computer and communication skills, things like that. There's also changes in the location of jobs. And an example of this could be if we have a factory that's located on one side of the country, which then closes down and moves to another side of the country, this is another example of structural unemployment because the jobs have gone from one location to another geographical location. We also have these things known as sunset industries, and the best example of this is if you think of VHS tapes. Nobody uses them anymore, so basically anybody who was in the industry of making VHS tapes is now no longer employed because the demand for these goods and services in, like, for example, VHS tapes, has now decreased. So the industry is kind of setting like a sunset. It's kind of diminishing slowly. The third type of unemployment that I want to talk about is cyclical unemployment. And this is simply just the higher than normal unemployment at a business cycle trough and the lower than normal unemployment at a business cycle peak. If we take a look, during a business cycle expansion, we have an increase in real GDP. So cyclical unemployment goes down because real GDP increases, firms produce more, they need more labor. But on the other hand, during a contraction, cyclical unemployment actually increases because as real GDP decreases, we have firms that can't sell as much goods and services, so they fire some people. Now we're going to put this all together. We're going to talk about natural unemployment. So natural unemployment is just equal to the structural unemployment plus the frictional unemployment. And the assumption here is that there is no cyclical unemployment. The effects of the business cycle are completely null. Natural unemployment is also known as the position where unemployment is at full employment. Let's take a look at this in an example. So we have a country with a working age population of 30 million. 18 million of these people are employed. 2 million are unemployed, and 2 million of the employed are working part-time, half of whom who wish to be working full-time. If 1 million of those unemployed are cyclically unemployed, what is the natural unemployment rate? Let's just take a second to highlight the important parts of this question. So we have 18 million that are employed, 2 million that are unemployed, and 1 million of those unemployed who are cyclically unemployed. So let's just remember this. When we say when we try to find the number of people who are naturally unemployed, we want to take the total amount and we want to subtract the cyclical people who are cyclically unemployed because they don't actually count as part of the natural unemployment rate. So we take the total, which is 2 million, and we take away 1 million, which is those who are cyclically unemployed, and we get a total of 1 million people who are naturally unemployed. And then we just put it into the same formula as the unemployment rate. We take the number of naturally unemployed and we divide it by the total labor force, which is 18 million plus 2 million, because that is the number of people employed, plus the number of people unemployed. And we divide that and then we multiply it by 100, and we get a natural unemployment rate of 5%.